In southern Oregon, the health of compulsive hoarder Louise continues to decline. And with the clutter in her home only getting worse, her children have insisted she sees a therapist before it's too late. But things begin awkwardly when psychologist Dr. Rebecca Beaton arrives at the house.
Hey, you must be Adam.
Yes.
I'm Dr. Becky.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Come on in.
Thank you.
When are we gonna get to get the house cleaned up?
Okay.
This is our home.
Hey, you must be Louise.
I've never walked into a hoarder's home and had the person just turn their back to me. That was a really strong message instantly that I was not welcome.
How are you feeling about me being here, Louise?
Ha, what a dumb question. I'm dealing with stuff, thank you.
How can any therapy help me? Because I already know what the problem is. What can I do for depression? Take certain vitamins.
Okay, so this is your living area, I take it?
Yes.
You mean living area? Yeah.
As soon as I walked into Louise's home, I noticed just a wall of items immediately on my right. And as I walked in, I saw more and more walls, which gave me the indication that Louise really hoards to keep herself safe more than anything.
This has been a difficult area. This is the kitchen. Stuff that we deal with in here. And our dining room is in there.
Wow, yeah.
There's a nice dining room table we used to sit at back around 2003, 2004. Maybe a little later than that.
And it's been a long time.
Stuff is piled up.
Mm-hmm. We have the
having assessed the state of the house, Dr. Beaton asks Adam and Louise to join her outside for a therapy session.
Curious to see what you're cooking with in the laundry room. Okay, so what I'd like you to do is I'm gonna give you 3 minutes, and I want you guys to come up with as many things as you can that you individually are willing to let go of. Okay? And we're gonna start now.
Okay.
Okay? You got 3 minutes. Let's go. Go, go, go.
Go fast. If you can go.
Adam went around and collected all kinds of items and filled up a complete shopping cart.
Anyway, this can go.
Louise, on the other hand, immediately sat down and didn't do anything.
Don't be touching this.
That's going. It's bad. Yeah, it is bad.
Why is it bad?
You can't let electronics sit out in the rain.
So you're gonna stand on it so you can't take it away?
No, because it's not going right now anyway.
Trying to treat two hoarders in one home who are almost diametrically opposed to one another about what they want to keep and what they want to let go of is a very, very challenging situation.
Talk to me why you're so attached to it.
Because I haven't gotten to study it yet.
Louise got extremely illogical about the printer.
For me and you, I don't think that would be wise to try to hang on to.
Then you pay me for this stuff, okay? How's that idea?
I kind of lost my temper and just wanted to get out of there and not deal with it for that moment.
All right, let's just focus on what we do have.
Hello? Okay?
No.
You gotta finish focusing on this.
Mama, try to be rational. You gotta think of rationality. You want me to pay you for that damage? When I probably found it for free and brought it home.
This is gonna be challenging moving forward. Adam wants to make some progress. Louise is going to be derailing us throughout this process.
Thanks everyone for coming today. So we're here to help Adam and Louise clean up their home. And we've written some rules down last night that we wanna make sure that we're really respectful of. So we wanna go over them real briefly. And then depending
it's cleanup day in Southern Oregon for compulsive hoarders Louise and Adam. Professional organizer Christine Bertelsen will be working with the family and a professional house clearance company with the aim of clearing out the entire building.
No, these rules are not right. Can I see the back of your note?
Yes, ma'am.
We've already talked about newspapers, something about that. And I have some open food, that doesn't mean it's no good.
Louise was obstinate from the start, She saw the rules once again and started denying ever agreeing to them. I knew we were in trouble at that point.
But while Louise is slow to start, Adam is enthusiastic, immediately labeling some items in the back garden for removal.
Okay, I think we'll have to...
Both of these ash tips, they're good.
All the red tags? Yeah. First thing this morning, I was getting a little worried. I had dry heaves a little bit, queasy the stomach. I didn't know, you know, how much work we're gonna get done. So I started here in the backyard, and then I just was able to make choices and make decisions that was to benefit us.
I think all the chairs and the furniture is going.
Okay.
Adam is cooking with grease. He's doing great. I think that we caught Adam just in the nick of time, where he's starting to realize that he's a hoarder and he is wanting to change things.
But while the skip is filling up outside, Louise is continuing to struggle inside.
These tea bags are way old. Where's my trash bag? Excuse me, that was in here, Marcella. Where's the trash bag that was hanging on here?
I don't know, I didn't touch it.
Well, ask who did and ask them to put it back. No, it was right here.
Was it trash?
It's my trash bag that I put right here so I can put trash in it. That's my trash bag for the kitchen.
Well, I didn't.
The one for the bathroom's in the bathroom.
If you touch my mother's things, you're pretty lucky to get out of there without getting beat up.
Can anybody not touch my stuff I got back here or what? Do I need to put some barbed wire in here or electrical devices?
I was trying to get the stove out here. Hopefully
eventually. Why? Would you please push it back now? I got stuff back here that I want hidden, that I don't want people taking. Now where is it? I don't see it.
Louise is battling cancer right now, and it's very severe.
This is insane, man.
I'm concerned that letting go of items will cause her so much stress that that will actually harm her more than help her.
Gosh darn it.
Okay, I'll grab you.
I think it's better if I do it myself. Because then it's done the way I want it. And I don't have to look or say anything and say this, that. It's better if I just throw it away and say, you don't need this, you don't need that. Do I do that to them? I don't think so. It's just sad.
Today, Marcella's sister, Sabrina, has come back to see the results.
If the house is not at least in the same condition as the last time I seen it, I'm gonna be very sad and depressed, and I don't want to do that. When I just walked into my mom's house, I was kind of disappointed. Well, a lot disappointed. When I went in, there was another pile.
How's it looking?
Yeah. What happened here? It is scary to think, you know, Marcella and Adam, and even my mom, they've done a lot of work in there. But it's just back.
Despite the continuing clutter in the living room,
wow,
some improvements have been made in the kitchen.
Great improvement. I see you have a sink. Does the water work?
Yeah.
Oh, my word. That is just fabulous. There's hot and cold running water in the kitchen. And that to me is awesome. That sink has been filled for years. You did a wonderful job.
Thank you, Sabrina.
I'm very proud of you.
Thanks.
Right now, it's just one day at a time.
A lot of work got done in here.
I think physically and mentally and spiritually and everything better. And I want to keep it like this.